What is common between a microwave oven, penicillin, and a pacemaker? Well, all of these inventions were accidents. A lot of great discoveries were made by accidents, but not all accidents are good. A slight miscalculation in chemical composition can result in a great disaster, like the one happened in 1921 in Germany. A place named OPPAU in Germany had a massive fertilizer plant, which produced a mixture of ammonium sulfate and ammonium nitrate. Massive amounts of ammonia could be easily produced at that point thanks to the Haber's process, developed by the Fitz Haber. This easy production of ammonia helped convenient production of fertilizers, which eventually increased the production of food many folds, and that helped feed a lot of people. And for this, he received the Nobel Prize in Chemistry. Ironically, it was the same scientist who weaponized chlorine in First World War and was called the father of chemical warfare. Ammonium sulfate is used on alkaline soils, where ammonium ion forms an acid and lowers the pH of soil, while adding nitrogen for plant growth. But nitrogen content is low in it, so ammonium nitrate is added into it, which provides high levels of nitrogen. But ammonium nitrate is also a major constituent in explosives. This fertilizer mixture usually forms a plaster-like solid due to its weight and moisture. So whenever it was needed, the workers had to use pickaxes to get it out. But the problem was that they always faced the risk of being buried alive. Also, the pickaxes were really slow. So one day someone came up with an idea of using dynamite to loosen the mixture. Though it was known at that point that ammonium nitrate was explosive, but this suicidal process was pretty common. It was based on tests in 1919 that indicated that if the mixture had less than 60% nitrate, it won't explode. And the plant was using the mixture in 50-50 ratio. So it was considered safe. But this theory did not work on 21st September at Silo 110, when a massive blast happened which instantly killed 560 people in the plant. The explosion was so loud that it was heard 300 kilometers away. 80% of the buildings of OPPAU were destroyed, leaving 6,500 people homeless. The pressure wave generated blew roofs and windows up to 30 kilometers away. Later on, it was found that less than 60% theory of nitrate was inaccurate. It was also dependent on humidity and density, which would change during an alteration in manufacturing process a few months before. There were also evidences of non-uniform composition, and several tons of enriched mixture of nitrate were also found. Ammonium nitrate is a dangerous compound, and a lot of countries are phasing out its commercial use due to potential misuse. This incident told the world about dangers of this compound and how a flawed assumption can be disastrous. If you want to see more videos like this, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to click the notification bell, like, comment, and share. And as always, keep learning, keep exploring until you know everything.